Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it's going to be a quick intro. We're not going to do the long one. You're watching Mad Gamer, Core Battle League in the building. As you know, we're going to start continuously bringing the Core Battle League presentation to you guys. Brought to you by MadGamer.com, which is coming back very strong, hopefully, in a new way. But get hyped, get into it. Today is a dribble day. I don't have my dribble build on, and I'm still going to show you guys what you can do even without it, right into the gameplay. I'm currently in the building with Cloudy Chip TV. His name says Doughboy there, but really is Cloudy Chip TV is his brand. And he usually plays other type of builds. He doesn't play a play shot. So I wanted to give a quick historian. So I want to try to give him some tips on that. He's played in real life. I've played against him. He's beaten me plenty of times. We went back and forth. He's a good player. He understands basketball. He's a fan. So this isn't some rookie not knowing basketball. 2K basketball is a different beast. And unless you just understand it, the philosophy behind it is hard. So the first lesson is you can't get taught everything, right? If I give you the tools and tell you to fix my car, you're not going to be able to fix the car unless someone actually shows you what to do and where to do it. And then even if that is the case, if I teach you how to fix the engine, you know about the radiator or the muffler or the tires or any of those things. So there's many layers to dribbling. There's not going to be a day that I can do one video unless I give you a good multiple hours on how to do that. So we're not going to go through all of it, but what I am going to do is show you the toolbox, teach you a couple of concepts, and then some in-game situations that are critical to understand, right? So first and foremost, you're not playing basketball. Sorry to say it. When you're online, it's not possible to just play basketball. And the first thing that I'm going to teach Doughboy is, Doughboy, I want you to do a suicide drill. So the number one move is right left cheese is what they call it in the world, right? So you're going to go from this hash where I'm at right now. You see this hash right here? All the way from this hash to the other hash and then hit a crossover with the right stick and then come back all the way over here. So do it as fast as you can. Yep. Okay. But I'm going to showcase it. And the reason I'm going to showcase it is because what we want to do is speed boost, right? Out of those situations. It's going to be very hard for people to speed boost when you do this crossover and you take a half hour to do the animation. It's not worth doing that long crossover. We're playing a video game, and in video games, speed kills. So as I get through, I can't just crossover. It's going to take forever. So you can see Doughboy did it a couple times. See how he's taking that long dribble to actually bring the ball back? He's going to kill himself. Defensively, you give me time to get close to you or steal it. So it is not okay. So the first thing you want to learn is pretty much letting go of everything as you go right here. So Doughboy is going to run to one side. He's going to let go of everything, then do the crossover. So you see the small stand still for a second, Doughboy. If you can give me this crossover right here. Just back and forth, quick flick stick up, flick the stick up with no turbo. You see that little dribble that I'm doing back and forth? All right. So with that dribble, I want to do that, but I'm going to do that right while I stop. This is a skill-based situation. It's going to be very hard for you to learn this right away, but basically you're going to move, hit, and then you're going to go to the opposite side, hit, go to the opposite side, hit. If I do it wrong, I'm going to get that long animation. So Doughboy, go back and forth like I'm doing and try not to do the long crossover. So you're going to flick the right stick up with turbo. You hear me, bro? So I'm going to move towards the left, hit to the right, and move to the right, go back and forth, nonstop, basically. See, and that's not what I want. Nope, I want one quick crossover, and then I'm back. Let go of everything, flick the right stick up only, and then go. Run with turbo, Let it all go. Nope. See, that's the long crossover you don't want. There you go. He did it once. That's what he, now I'm going to have a hard time staying in front of him. If he's doing that in a game, it's going to be harder for me to stay in front of him. If he does it the other way, hold turbo and do the same thing so you can, they can see the slow motion version. No. Keep running and then hit turbo. And then cross over. He's not doing it. I'll do it here. So basically, this long crossover is the unhealthy thing that most people will do. And what you want to do is let it all go, flick the stick so you can move, and then go forward. All right, that sounds silly and it sounds basic, but trust me, it's going to help you from doing things like the long crossover where you're taking half hour to get there. And the people will steal the ball or they'll get in front of you. You won't be able to have a shot. Okay, with that in mind, that is the first thing. Now, with that, we're going to teach some hezzies and things like that that are very critical. And again, this is going to take practice. Doughboy is supposed to be doing this for 15 minutes, but we're going to kind of speed him through this. 15 minutes nonstop, going back and then move, going back, then move, and then being able to speed it up and not do the long crossover. Go ahead, Doughboy. See, he did the wrong crossover right there that one time. The second time he did a little better on the speed. And until he can do it over and over and over without going through the long crossover, he is not good. And the normal routine is from the three-point line all the way down until this line right here. And just keep going back. And if you do the long crossover, you're pretty much messed up. And we're watching his movement. And you can see sometimes he'll do the long crossover and it's bad. It's not what you want. So you're paying attention to his movement, not mine's, because that's what matters. He's learning this method. If you're a casual, like I play sometimes casually, so I do that crossover that I don't want to do sometimes because I don't practice this enough to master it. It's just a quick change of direction without getting stuck in a long animation. But that alone is going to change your game, right? But what is the real dribble moves and what do we need to learn to do it in combination to things? So Doughboy, can you come over here? This is a really, really, really good challenge. At the free throw line, stand right here on the opposite side. See, and he's getting that already. He's going to be a problem now. The problem with Doughboy specifically, and a lot of you guys, you run straight forward towards a player and you get the ball plucked and then you get mad. I got 99 dribbles. What the hell? Well, stop running towards people. This is going to be the move to teach you to start off your dribbles or to work into a combination. All right. So Doughboy, get on the other side of this. So the move is a combo. This is good for Doughboy. He's a fighting player. So he's going to flick the right stick up. Just flick it up real quick, which gives him the quick crossover. Right after that, it's going to be a doom, 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 doom. He's going to flick down on the left stick. Flick up on the right stick and flick there. Almost had it. See. So this is how it looks. You see right there? And this is basically a step back. Yep, you got it. Doom, doom. And do it again. Nonstop. All the way till you get to the end of the next free throw line. Keep going back. Come on, bro. I'm going to beat him there. I don't do this as much as I should, but this right here. So this move, the reason why this is important, and again, I'll remind everybody on stream, I don't have the camera on, but flick the right stick up, no turbo, no anything. You could just flick the right stick up and the left stick down. Boom, 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 boom. That's all I'm doing. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Why is this important? I'm about to start up a dribble, and I can speed boost to the right out of it. Whichever side the ball is going to be on when I do it is the side I want to speed boost towards after. And then I'm going to speed boost. So, Doughboy, when you do it once, head towards where the ball is right after. So So you can go forward, left, right, whatever. For me, I like to move towards the right, and I just go from there. Small little quick speed boost. So boom, speed boost. Head out where I'm going. That little boost might get me an opening for a dunk, opening for a three, whatever it is I'm looking for, whatever I can get. It's never, this is how you do combinations. There's no combination in basketball. It's a fluid sport. So in one moment you get three, the next moment you can drive, the next moment you got to kick it out. So this is a very critical move, and this is going to teach you not to get the ball stolen, basically. This one move right here. Because you start off and you're going to have to wait until they react to decide what your move is. So when you do that, if they push close, you can try to get around them, get to the basket, and score quickly. Or, you know, pop up for a three, whatever the case may be. And now with that in mind, oh boy, so we're going to move towards one side and we're going to do a hezzy with turbo and the right stick to the right at the same time, right? See this right here? See that little hezzy? See how long it takes for me to do it? I don't want to do it that long. All I want is this right here. Turbo. Nope, nope. Don't give me a full animation. This ain't basketball. This is 2K. I need boom and I'm out. I just did the hezzy too. Boom and I'm out. I'm not letting it go further. No, I don't want the whole hezzy. I want to go towards the hezzy. You want to go towards the hezzy. There you go. So he got it once right there. And that's what you want to do every time. Quick hezzy, but you want to hit it at the same time with the left stick right after so that you can get that quick speed boost and it's a problem for whoever's defending you. So that right there is another way to open up your offense. All of these can be combined in different ways. You're going to see all of them one after another later on, maybe when I play a game and I try to do it. So there you go. So that's the one, and that's a simple one, right? And it works very efficiently. Trust. It's a quick speed boost. Now the Derrick Rose, I believe you have this as on your package. Hold R2 and flick up towards the right to do the Derrick Rose. So you should be able to just do this back and forth, right? Come on. There you go. There we go. So we're in sync. So this move right here, you don't want to do it over and over and over nonstop. But if I do it once, I can go and make a play out of it. You know, let's just say I want to hit the opposite way when I do it and go this way. So you saw me do a combination right now with the step back just real quickly. There's different ways to go. But that little Derrick Rose will also give you the space you need to move or to do whatever. Sometimes I like to do a double hezzy. So I'll do the Derrick Rose and then do a hezzy and then just speed boost after out of it. Depending on the defense. Like I told you, our game sense isn't the same as just teaching you, giving you the tools. Giving you the tools, but on the game, if I go like this and he's not there, I can shoot it, I can drive, whatever I'm going to do. But let's say I do the Derrick Rose, he's still in front of me. I'm just going to hezzy again and see what else is there. And hit them with a speed boost, trying to go the opposite way or whatever. This is where you combine things like the behind the back, the escape dribbles. I'm not going to go through these tutorials. This is just straight up some of the key ones, which is run, let go of everything, crossover, come back the other way. Don't do this long crossover, take you a half hour. Somebody's going to steal it or at least be in front of you. You just got to let go of everything while you're running, go to the opposite side and just go. It's the easiest way I could explain that one. Then secondly, the right stick up and then left stick down to do that little snatch back, step back, which is going to basically give you a moment to prepare for your combo or whatever it is you want to do. Personally, I like to do that. And then if I see if they're going to steal, I'll put it behind my back and escape out of it. So, I mean, these are just basic moves, but the point of it is for you guys to utilize it in combination. Once you start practicing them fully, you're going to be unstoppable. Never go forward on a play if there's somebody right there. So what Doughboy is doing is going to get him. This is why the left right cheese is so important in 2K, because you will get plucked even with 99 dribble. It's not going to be that easy for you. So just work on those would be my best advice. You know, there's a lot of other moves that I'm kind of showcasing the half step right there, which is one of my favorites. But it's not always useful unless you're a master at knowing how to manipulate the defense. The main useful ones are everything I just showcased. Run, let go, hit the other side. And it sounds silly, but it's literally just like that. And I, of course, there's more advanced. Once you get really good with it, you can start adding some things to make it flavorful. But those are the main combinations, up and then down. See that snatch back, step back? Very critical. If you can't do this one, you're in trouble because you're going to need it. People are going to play great defense. They're going to try to steal the ball. And if you hit them with that as they go to steal, you can speed boost right out of it. And for Doughboy, he needs to practice that one the most because that's the one he mentally needs to put into his bag so that he won't have turnovers or have any issues on dribble with his build. Are you following me so far, Doughboy? So, do you feel like you can do both, all three of those on demand? Well, I did like four of them, but...
Hey, you're talking about this one right here? This one right here?
Yep. You're doing it better, smoother. What's this? Can do it a little faster, a lot faster, but yeah. I mean, I'm 6 foot seven, and I can do it faster than you can. If we did a race right now, I'll probably beat you.
I'm trying to go faster, but it's not going faster. That's a different move.
No, it's the same move. See, this crossover is doing it wrong. The one I'm doing right now is the way you do it wrong. Then you do it right. You just click, you're out of there. Click, out of there. Click, out of there. And it's real glitchy, and it's real hard to deal with. Yeah. All right, so then can you do the step back?
The step back, yeah. Let me see if I can go all the way. Do a race to see who can make it over there first.
You don't want no smoke. I gotta go to the center because this thing is pulling me out. This dude caught a rhythm, bro. Get out of here, dog. He got it. So there you go. So that's a critical one for Doughboy. And it's not just that move in general. Never move towards the players. You want to move to the left, to the right, or back. So there are times I do the hezzy and I'll come back. I'm not going towards them or forward. I'm going back.
That's what you're talking about, this, right?
So I'll do a hezzy and I'll go backwards. Right there. Yep. The hezzy speed boost. Heavy speed boost towards the way you're going. Yep. Vroom. It's hard to deal with. And then if you just come back with the speed, the second moves, and now you're combining all of those together, it's harder to defend you. For example, this big Derrick Rose, and I hit him with the step back, behind the back, easy three. All of that is just different combinations. The game sense is a different conversation that we won't do today as far as like breaking that down. I could do a whole long video on just game sense and breaking down footage. You can't do it during a game because it's hard to break it all down without slowing it down and showing y'all. But those are the pretty much the ideas. I'd like to thank Doughboy for giving me the moment to show him some of those moves, give him some of the, you know, simple ones, but they're basically the most critical. Without that, you can't really be a play shot. But those are it. And then again, sometimes I'm dragging back. I'm not dribbling forward pretty much ever unless I got a lane for a dunk. Most of the time I'm going left, right, or I'm doing a move to go back a little and get some space so that I could work my magic. Never forward. Forward is a bad thing. You know, and breaking people's ankles, for example, if we're going to talk about, that's something I like to do on my ISO head. I'm not really a pick and roll guy, but ISO, you need the person. If I have to be in front of Doughboy for him to break my ankle. Whatever moves he does, if I'm to the side of him, he's not going to break my ankle. Sometimes I'm on the side on purpose. I don't want my ankle broken by these players. So I'm like by the side. What's that?
In this move.
Can't hear you.
I was just doing it. This move.
Which one?
This.
Bro, it looks like you're just rotating the...
Yeah, but you see how is that what's happening? I'm glitching it right now.
Basically, yeah. I mean, all of that could work. Anything could work in the game. To be tell you all the truth, sometimes... I experiment and do wild stuff that I never do again. Basically, like, I don't know what the hell I just did there. I was trying some, rotating this way, and I've done some crazy ones. You know, like, remember, I don't think I have it on right now, do I? Man, I forgot how to do it. Sheesh. There it is. That right there where you're going back, but you're also trying to finesse to the three-point line, so you're faking like you're driving. Been a while since I've done it. And this is why people use basic on their spins. I can't do it again. Been a while. But y'all know what I'm talking about. This is one of the most fun moves to do if you're really good. I haven't done it. I used to do it. There you go. It's almost it. But yeah, the half step, there's a bunch of great moves. You just got to know how to combine them, as you saw me do a half step there. But that's what I got for y'all as far as general drills. This is supposed to be a quick guide. And the reason why I'm making it quick, they're just combinations.
That's how that works. I figured it out.
What? Yep.
So you do the spin move and then you aim the analogs, the left analogs at where you want to move. Just hold it, the left analog stick.
Yeah, that's the one I used to do. It's the basic. There it is right there. So that's a good move, but I haven't mastered it. Again, I stopped playing dribble head style, but pretty much it's down on the left stick while you're doing the spin towards the hoop. Doughboy got it mastered. Look at this. Oh, he did it sometimes.
I figured it out.
But again, these moves are not, all the other moves that I can showcase are not going to be the most important that are going to get you open. Right? These are moves that you add on. Once you've figured out all the rest, the most important ones, and you practice what I started off with, you actually master them consistently in game, not during a pro-am chilling, fooling around moment. It has to be in game, and that'll be the moment where you actually utilize it. First of all, y'all ain't paying me for this, bro. I used to do these coaching things, bro. I'm out here doing it for free today. But yeah, so those are some breakdowns on the general things. And of course, the SIGs and all this stuff that we will get into right after I leave this area. You don't have to have every SIG. People try to lie to you guys. You got to have this SIG. You got to have my exact SIGs. There's some SIGs you can replace with others. And it's all preference on some of them. For example, the Derrick Rose is a nice crossover. This is one that you probably don't want to lose out on. Right? And this isn't... The step back isn't the only player that does it. I believe there's like four of them that do it. I would have to go down a list to show y'all, which we're not doing today. This little step back, that move right there. Things like that are choice. And even this right here, this is one of the new moves that came out this year, which is basically misdirection. See that right there, that misdirection? That is the brand new move that came out this year, which is really good. But until you master regular moves, that one should not be in your bag right away. And I'm not even doing it right here. Sheesh. There it is. So basically, it's turbo and then act like you're going to do it behind the back while you're doing turbo. So right stick down to the right or the opposite where the ball hands, then after you go doom, doom with the left stick the opposite way. So boom. See right there? That's the combination. Adobo is good with combinations. So once again, do the behind the back. Like if you're doing a behind the back, just do this. Right after you do it in the doom, doom, one after another, you have to hit the left stick the opposite way. See, and that's it's a really good misdirection. You can get a lot of space, but if you're not a great player and you haven't figured out how to really manipulate the defenders, there's no reason to put this in your bag and try it on games, especially when you're playing with other players. If you're on offline testing this out, cool, go for it. You know, but when you're playing with people, experimenting is not worth it. So that's pretty much it right there. I don't even do that move that much. I love it. I love it. And I've done it a few times on Pro-Am. I mean, on Rec, but it's not the best when it comes to when you're not really going hard on these dribble moves. As I said, I stopped being a sweat bag and just chill casually. So personally, I play casually. So even me teaching Doughboy is also me reminding myself of some things and stop doing bad habits while I play. You know, I'm laying back on the sofa, not playing serious. And then all of a sudden I do this crossover to turn instead of doing my actual speed crossover. I'm doing this long crossover that can get robbed easily if I don't do it right. So there's that. Those are pretty much it right there when it comes to it. That's pretty much what I got for y'all. All right. And that's it. Doughboy, do you feel like you learned anything? I feel like he knew a lot of moves. It's more about putting them into motion. The main one was the first one, which is actually not even a move. It's just stop spamming turbo and all the buttons to cross over when you're trying to change directions. Let it all go, then do a move, then go. Why? Because you want to be able to speed out of it. You don't want to. And this comes, you can get so fast with this that people can't keep up just from this one move that we started off with. So that is my challenge. And I'm not trying to be a terrible tutorial guide here to teach people the right and left cheese, but you have to have this in your game for the pick and roll or just in general to try to get some space. Anyway. But yeah, season 2 is coming around this Friday. And they put out an update. Doughboy is going to be making a new build. What's your build? What's your build, man?
I want a slasher.
Yeah, for sure. I would take you as a 6'6 slashing, defending, lockdown. You know, ridiculous lockdown that's like scary to be next to.
I don't really even need a lot of shots. It's going to be pure. It's going to be literally a two-way slasher. It's going to be pure defense and slashing.
Exactly. No, because what you got to guys understand, if he pulls that build out, I was thinking about it today because he said this to me the other day. I already knew he was going to say that. So in my head, I'm pulling out my 6'7", which is this guy right here. He's basically a point guard. He's really not a point guard because he got like crazy defense. He can guard big men. But with me and Doughboy, with Doughboy with a 6'6 build, pure slasher. And me with a 6'7 point guard who can dribble and do, you can see all the moves I can do. I basically could run it up. Me and him together can do something crazy, but he would need to have like a 90 plus something rebounds for us to be viable. Because if not, we're going to be in trouble. But other than that, it would be perfect because we can switch on every person we guard. You know, in 2K, you don't want to, like, the versatility of having like 2 6'6" or 6'7" players can be crazy. I'll make a 6'6" center. That's how crazy 2K is right now. I could make a 6'6" center. He'll have like a 94 rebounds, which could compete against these other centers. And then from there, just be a monster with defense. So, all right, man, we out of here. We gonna go. You said you learned something new?
Yeah, I still gotta practice the dribbles, bro. It's gonna be a while for me to muscle memory to remember this whole thing.
Oh, yeah, I know. But the point is that to put those into use, because even me, I play casually right now, and I'll go crossover. Like, I told you not to do the cross, and I'm doing this long crossover like a dumbass. And it's not because I'm a bad player that I don't know. It's called casual playing, where you're not really thinking of being good. You're just kind of just want to chill, and you play the game, and you're doing terrible habits. It's like how we eat bad food, and we always, I just want to, let me eat, let me have a good time. We always tell ourselves we're having a good time, and then you're eating ice cream every day for months, like I did, which is unhealthy.
Is that the cheese?
Huh?
Is that the cheese?
Is that the cheese right there?
Yeah.
It's the cheese, but until you get it perfect, you did it good right there. It's like once out of every 15 that you do, you'll do a perfect one. The small amount, this is what people don't get, like, yeah, we're teaching you how to do this, but the small amount that it takes me to go over versus you, for example, like, I'm slower as hell, bro. Like, I'm literally 6'7" with like an 80 overall in speed. You're like a 94 overall in speed, and I can do it faster than you, not because of anything other than just I practiced this a long time ago, years ago, and then I can do it so quick. You know, and it looks like I'm faster than you. I'm not. I'm just turning the corner quicker, getting around without making that mistake of doing the long dribble. You do the long dribble, then, you know, if we did a contest, the way the contest works is from this 3-point line, we come all the way down to here. We go back and forth 5 times, see who can do it the fastest. And then the thing is as you're doing this dribble, it's all about once you get here, how fast you're crossing to the opposite side while doing the crossover. Boom, get that little speed boost, cross, quick. And that's the difference in players who's are skilled or who's not, basically. Anyone can do what I'm saying, and you will do what I'm saying, but you probably won't do it in the fastest speed possible. If you can do it in a quicker way where you can really, really take over without doing all the extra bad animations, you'll be good. So those are the main tricks. And the problem is when you get into a game and you're just chilling, it's just like a fight. You know, when I used to train, my mindset was in fight mode. So if you fight me at any point, I'm going to do some damage naturally. Other people never fight, so they get hit. Do fight or flight. They don't know what to do and they get panicked and then they freeze. It's because they don't have that natural instinct. That's why guys like Kobe or Jordan practicing over and over became the greatest, because they just didn't stop. Every day they'll train, obsessed. So that's the difference. If you want to get good, even me, I know I can be good, but I just play casually, you know. And that's my problem as far as, like, if I want to get better on this, and I'm not even doing it as fast as one of these sweat bags would do. So those are the principles, and that's just one move, and that's not really the biggest move, but it's important. So that, and then things like the hezi, knowing the timing. The hezi is a little easier, in my opinion. You do the hezi and that speed from the hezi. Oh, man, it's hard to deal with. Somebody's guarding you. You're moving this way. Hit them with a hezi, and you go back again, forcing them to. So imagine I'm on the corner. I get the ball. I fake like I'm going. I stop with a hezi. Oh, and then I hit them again. It's easy three. It's just my imagination, but it's basically like shadow boxing. And this principle goes with everything. So I cross them up. I got here. Faked like I was going to do. Hit them with another hezi. If I do the long hezi, the whole hezi, look how long this hezi is. It's a lot. I don't need all that. If I do it the right way, I'm out of there. I just did it. You didn't notice it, but it's there just to get that speed boost. So activating the speed boost is what matters most. So yeah, that's the lessons. But it takes habit. It ain't going to be a day for anyone, anybody, even myself, who knows these things and taught some guys these things. not easy. All right, enough, man. Doughboy, thank you very much for being a participant on this, man. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, thank you.
So you gonna make that 90-90 today or tomorrow? You get 30 badges. Well, actually, I think you get more than 30. You get the college.
That's what I'm saying. Is that like a whole thing?
Right now, what you got to do is go activate it. Let's go outside real quick.
You just have to play games, right? Or you have to
You got to play 10 games. Let's go do that real quick. I'm going to go outside. I can show these animations real quick. I don't really care. Have you seen Ash's abilities? Oh my god. No. Send me them. All right, so quick look at the attributes while I talk to Doughboy. Doughboy, go to your quest and look up city or something. I don't even know what it's called, man. Here, okay. The main ones you would want to have is Derrick Rose size up. I love that. Size up. Escape package. Go to your quest and then look for rebirth. You want to have Curry crossover. K.
Oh, I got it right here. Rebirth.
Yep. Activate it real quick. And then go to that guy. Kawhi Leonard behind the back. I mean, moving behind the back. Moving spin basic. The reason it was basic is to be able to do that little spin back to the three, which I haven't used in like 2 years. So I.
Do you have to play all those games in one session or no?
If you can get them all done yet. Moving hesitation is Kevin Durant. Moving step back is Jimmy Butler. Yeah, and then that's it.
Get all those sessions done today.
10 games in a 3-on-3 or 2-on-2? Where's the guy? Have you talked to? Have you activated him?
I'm talking to him now.
10 games. You could do that in less than an hour, dude. What are you talking about?
Oh, well.
You can do it faster than that. If we win quick. Okay, that's a Dribble tutorial. Hey, yo, send me the info, money, bro. Are we in the same park?
Yeah.
Meet me at Beach from the East.
Oh no, I'm not in the same park. You left.
Hold on, don't join on me yet. Let me go to Beach from the East first. All right, we're here.
All right, you want me to join you?
Who are these people? That ain't my friends list. Yeah. I don't got my friends list no more. Is this my friend list? This is my friend list. Damn, who are these people? Oh my god. Actually, we can't go into a squad, bro. Don't join my squad. Send me a link on Discord. All right, man. Meet me at, I don't even know. Want to do twos?
Yeah, we get games quick.
Are you ready for to do twos?
I just want to get the 10 games done.
All right. All right, let's go to 3-on-3 right there in the middle. Got to get there quick before somebody steals it. No. The middle one. This is how you know he's casual. He's still kind of got some brown shirt right now. And he got the brown plate.
It's a nice shirt, bro. I need some shoes is what I need. Alright, yo, give me a second, bro.
I'm looking at her skins, bro. I don't want to see her skins. I want to see her abilities, bro. Where it at? Those are nice, though. I ain't going to lie. Oh, there it goes. There it comes. Oh. All right. What can she do? Is that the car? That's the car? Holy smokes, that's the car. First of all, we do not promote this on our stream. Stop leaking people's... Those thousands of dollars go into making these things. I don't see her ability getting popped. There it is. She got a ninja star? What the hell does that do? Oh, so it's like an arc star that sticks to people? That'll like track them or something? And she got a blade. What does it do? Deflect bullets? Bro. I'm not paying attention, bro. I'm on stream. But, that looks interesting. That looks interesting. I could dig it. Deflecting bullets could be interesting. To get some what?
Pita bread and hummus. I'm hungry. I shouldn't be eating at this time, but.
Yo, my mom was talking about getting the. That, what's it called? The tuna? She said she wanted to get it for Ruben. I think she's going to get it for her damn self. Ruben don't care about that. Ruben want to go to gym and see some big booty girls. He ain't thinking about working out in the house. You know, he's trying to get away. You know what I mean?
That tunnel's off the hook, nigga.
It is. Though I told her. When she showed it to me, I told her, I said, Mom, this thing is fire. But I don't think you need it. Because Ruben want to go to the gym. I didn't tell her he want to go see big booties. I think I did tell her that. But I'm like, Ruben want
to
go see some big booties.
You know, you still want to have...
No, if you can have it at the house, sure. What's going on, Edgar? Thank you for coming. We just checked out the new leak for the new character that's coming out. When is that releasing? Bro, my head is swivered. It's in November, isn't it? November 3rd? Guys, y'all don't even know what I've been doing, man. I got this old projects that I'm bringing back for survival. Even Doughboy. Oh, man. Doughboy never listens to me, so. You'll see, Doughboy. But, so my head hasn't been in the game, man. So, give me the release date. November 3rd for the Apex season. New character, new map.
For November 19.
It's in my head. I don't remember. Is it 19? What are you talking about November 19th?
Battlefield.
Oh. No, the 21st, actually. See, you just helped me remember.
The 21st?
You got level 40? Yeah, man, I got level 40 without trying, bro. I would have got level 40 in the weekend, the first week. Because they had double XP that weekend. But I wasn't really playing. I was playing offline. I maxed out 3 characters before I got to level 40. Offline, basically, playing my career, doing all that stupid stuff. Yo, Battlefield Doughboy, the only problem I got with it, those visual bugs and stuff, they need to address that. They fixed a lot of them from the beta, but it's still there on some of them. Wait a minute, November 2nd the game? No, it doesn't. I thought the new map launches on the 21st. Am I bugging out? All right, we got to talk basketball right now. The boy has to carry me. He's trying to put me in here against a 7-footer. I'm 6'7" with only like an 80 rebounds. It's supposed to be a point guard build. He's supposed to make his center 6'6 or 6'7 with 90 rebounds. I didn't do that. I think I shrunk my hands a little. But if he makes his build, gotta hope that this guy doesn't. This dude worried about calories. He just had a big ass burger with two slices of cheese pizza, and he ate ice cream with his girlfriend a couple minutes ago. I mean, like I was saying earlier, we got bad habits, and we say, just let me live. I'm just doing me. I'm enjoying myself. Oh, he's actually not that tall. My boy, give me the ball. Thank you. These cats are dead in the water if they keep fooling around. Wait. Back. I got you, son. Oh, no, they're giving you the three. Bro, this dude bricking on me. Hey, man, let's confirm some things, people. The Apex season, we don't even have to clear it. Let me get that. You ain't gonna let me get that? See this dude, bro? He's selling, bro. He's selling the... He's looking like a random, bro. Oh, my God. Don't reach. He got me. That's my fault. Give me the exact date when the new map is coming out, when the new character's coming out, and when the new gun... I just seen the car. I know that it's coming, but I want to know the date officially. Beautiful defense. Give me that ball, boy. This guy doesn't respect me. You gotta hit it, bro. No. Oh my. I got him. Get back to the... He missing wide opens. That's crazy. Come on. What do you think you're doing, bro? You know who I am? Are you serious? That's my fault, bro. I'm not supposed to do standing shots. It's a driving build. This guy could shoot, though. I couldn't defend there. Somebody help me out. Give me the date. I thought it was the 3rd. So now you saying the 2nd? And I thought it was the 22nd, 1st? It's definitely the 2nd then, right? November 2nd? Damn, this dude's toasting, Doughboy. I'm gonna have to give up the 3. Yep. Oh, he dunked on me. Blame Doughboy for all this. Get out of here, my boy. I ain't gonna pass the ball no more, bro. I don't trust Doughboy no more. Give me the ball. Oh, this dude. Doughboy got me playing like a terrible player. I'm gonna give him the ball again. Let's see if he can do it. Give me one, bro. Thank you. November 2nd officially. Thank you. Okay. Apex Legends, new season. November 2nd. Maybe I'll get my life back together. Yep. Get a little closer to the 3. There you go. If you get a little closer, it'll give you a bigger green. You're a little bit out from it. Get close to the line as possible. Look at this. They want the little guy to get toasted. Do you not know that I could dunk on your face all game?
Oh my God. Wow.
92 overall dunk basically means any midget like that would never stop me. Don't shoot. Don't shoot. This big guy can't stay in front of me either, so he got to play. Look at you. Ready? Beep. Oh, no. I just messed it up. I'm sorry, Doughboy. It was supposed to be a dunk. I did a mid-range. It's those terrible moments. Stay on him. Stay on him. I'm going to block the rest of these times he drives. We should be winning this game. I don't know how we're down right now. Got to change my badges, too, for two-on-twos. All right. Only down five. It's not a lot compared to how bad we've been playing. No. Now we're in trouble. We can't give the ball back if we get it. Big man's not going to sell no more. So it's going to be this little guy. He knows I want to block the life out of him. Can't do it. Basically, your build is supposed to be an offensive scare monster, but. Nope. You better miss that. Boy, sell. Thank you.
Won't give it to me.
Back, back. I missed. It's all right. Give me that ball. Oh, so, man, I'm selling. I'm selling, guys. I did the same thing Doughboy did. I was shooting from a little further out than I should have. It's all me.
My guy can hit from there.
Oh, I can hit from there too, but it's not. You get a little extra percentage shooting if you get right on that line. He wants a three. He knows I'm going to come for him. He got it too. We should have won that. All right, let's change our badges, bro.
I have the badges you put on.
I don't even remember what I have. I'm going to change mine real quick. Change mine because this is my 5-on-5 type of setup. Everybody signing up for the event tomorrow. Thank you very much. I appreciate y'all, man. Why y'all wait until I'm busy to sign up? Come on now. Hey, Doughboy, find a game while I do this real quick.
I did. I'm right here. You gotta come here.
All right, hold on a second. All right, so we got. I'm gonna change this up just a little. Turn up the mouse in the house. I'm gonna. I don't have my hot zones just yet. See, I'm supposed to depend on Doughboy. He's a offensive juggernaut. He's supposed to carry me.
I'm still getting used to like the lag and the online. Not the same.
You're right.
Putting me offline is way different. Like I can kill it offline with the shooting. It's just online. I have to get used to it. I don't play enough online.
I agree.
I have to get used to like the trying to stay in front of somebody with the lag being a part of that whole thing.
I agree.
It doesn't feel like offline at all.
I agree.
That's my biggest thing.
I agree. I concur. All right, we're going to go with this selfish play right here. I'm going to go crazy right now. I got to be the GOAT right now. Hold up, hold up. Gotta get some rebounds. And. What? I don't got interceptor? Oh, this is my one-on-one, that's why.
Bro.
No, it's 6-12.
You bet. There you go, I see you. Alright, let's go, man. You didn't work on your build, your dribbles, huh? I mean, your badges, huh?
No, because I already have the ones that you put for the street.
There's different ones, bro. You gotta have one for the twos, one for the threes, and one for the fives. Literally. That's why they got new loadouts. I love it that they got loadouts, because that means I can switch it up. All right, we're good to go. I think I'm going to change this. Yeah, we'll leave it on. Shout out to everybody. Damn, bro, I only got 5,000 VC, bro. You know how hard I grind for VC, bro? I wasted everything making my four builds. And then they got a 99 thing, bro. I shouldn't have made one build, waited until the new season. Oh, man. Could all be so simple. Yeah, I think from now on, Dobo, you should play online only. What's your let me look at your build real quick. I don't think it needs much else, right? Like as far as stats goes. Yeah, like all you want to do is put that passing up next time you upgrade. Get it at 86. That way you can have gold bullet pass, gold bailout. You want those two activated. So get that to an 86 at least. After that, you should probably speed up your speed and acceleration to max, because then you're really, really going to be glitchy. And you got a 90 plus on everything necessary. Three-pointers, dribbling, shooting. It's a savage. Just got to go savage right now. We're going to lose. We're going to lose in great fashion. Gotta go savage, man. Your build is unguardable. Anybody watching that knows 2K, they'll be like, yeah, that's a real play shot. This dude going ham. Only problem is he has to go ham. You have 5 total games played in the city. I hit the wrong button.
Yeah, no, I haven't played much. But I usually play with you guys.
5 games, 4 turnovers, 45% from the field, 2 games played in rec, 26% from the field. Damn. 3 turnovers. And that's pretty much your stats. So that's why y'all see, like, he ain't supposed to be sweaty. Everybody knows I don't try to be sweaty anyways. I just chill. Honestly, if 2K wasn't glitchy, didn't have that play style we were just showcasing earlier, Doughboy, you would be a better player. Because you would rely on more actual basketball fundamentals. But since they got the whole right left cheese, the whole, you know, poke system, it's a little difficult. But yeah, man, I want you to let loose right now, bro. A The problem is you want to let loose in the wrong sting, bro. We could go to threes, and you're able to really let loose. On twos, one mistake, you won't get the ball back. That's what's hard about twos. And right now, you're playing a real sweat. He's 5'9". He's going to do everything. Everything we showed in the beginning of the stream. This is your time to see it happen. Oh, the way to guard it is to stay on him and go over screens. Don't even bother to try to fight through them or go under them. Just go over them. And then I have to help on them. So I'm going to have to do chase down blocks all game. Don't worry about the center ever. You're just going to stay on this guy like glue the whole game. Oh, man, it's going to be a problem. But we're going to force that guy to pass it. The center's going to get a lot of points in the paint, and I have to find a way to get chase down blocks during that time. But here it comes, exactly what we were talking about. Exactly what's supposed to happen. Dude's got high win percentages. Sweat bags. This is their new builds that they just made today after having like 6 builds already maxed out. Oh, man. There you go. If they don't pass it to him, then, give me the ball, boy. You're going to get robbed. I'm about to win if he can keep doing this.
And the slasher has really good steals. 99, bro.
The who?
The slasher robs people with...
This guy wildin', bro. What you think you're gonna do on me, bro? You selling the life out of it, dog. He definitely wildin'. Get away from me, bro. My own teammate selling me out right now. Go all the way away from me. Little man gonna rob my ass. Get off me, big boy. Get off my nuts. I knew this little scumbag was going to get me. Give me the ball, bro. I'm mad. My fault, though, boy. Should have kicked it when he came. He went under my legs to steal it. Yeah, that's what I want. Come on, player. Not going to happen, bro. Might as well pass the ball, bro. Get out of here, son. What? Okay. They actually even haven't started to play glitchy. They're letting this big guy. I think they know it's me. Little scumbags. That's how we doing this today? He got me with the speed. The cheesy speed. For centers. I do it all the time with my center. I can't blame him. Not even that big, though. He's like a 6'8", 6'9". No, Doughboy, why are you ball watching? The one thing you're supposed to do, you can't block my guy, so there's no need to help. Never help. Just let them figure it out. Bro, I didn't jump. It's fine. I'm getting cooked here. Good stuff. Got nice dribbles. I can't get a block. Catching me. It's not even letting me jump. It's sticking me in the contact dunk animation. Once you trigger you in there, you're stuck. Wow. I owe Doughboy a game if I lose this. I'm definitely going to shut him down right now. I've been giving him too much space. I'm not going to respect him now. I'm going to go all out. Thank you, sir. You better pass the ball, though. I'm actually tight. Go ahead. See you later, dumbass. I'm mad. 9 seconds. Don't foul. This guy want to make a video about me. Give me that. Sucker. Bruh. I'm gonna foul out of this game, bruh. I don't think I ever foul out of a twos game in my life. Here it comes. No, I did actually. I think I did once. I'm feeling right now. Scumbag, bro. He's using a quick drop. Everybody, I told y'all yesterday or two last week, quick drop the best. Only way to trigger that is holding the right stick up as you hit turbo to dunk. He's really not that good. I've just been playing very casual. Bro, why are you ball watching? You're 6 foot tall. You ain't going to stop him no matter what you do. Stay on that guy. I know I'm getting cooked. I'm terrible right now. You could say that. Tell me that. Say you suck right now. I'll take that. Look at this guy trolling me right now. My defense is suspect right now. This guy's nice with it, though. I'm not even going to lie. Let me get that. It's my turn now. My boy. No, he ain't. Not him. If you... Bro. Bro, get away from me. This dude is pulling a Roy. I don't need your pick. You're 6 foot. Give me my space if I have the ball. Just like I do for you. And he walks. Oh, man. That's like a troll right now. And we lost because of it. Oh, I got it. Just let me work, bro. Let me work. Sucker. No, bailout. Little man's in trouble. Nope. I'll just shoot it, bro. That's my fault. I sold this out. I sold this out this whole game, man. Anyone. Big man can't guard me one-on-one. Little man is the main issue. Get my energy back. My energy is low. All right, we can't make a mistake, bro. I made every mistake. It's my fault we're losing. I apologize. If I get the ball, though, I just want to do me. Damn, this dude is ridiculous, bro. Falling out next play. Got a chase down block on me and everything. I don't remember the last time this build got toasted like this. I'm not used to big man doing everything he's doing. That's why. Game time right now. Oh boy, you got to come in clutch, bro. Be ready for the shot. The little man has to help. I'm going to kick it to you every time, but little man has to. Bro. I swear. Finally. Third block, but not good enough. Who got 13 on my head? This game, I sucked. The worst defensive game I've had on twos this year.
I wasn't bad.
It's terrible, bro. Nah, bro. I could have stopped him a lot more. I don't know. Couldn't trigger my. You gotta go and do your thing, bro, on this next game because you're supposed to take over. You just let me. Let's go to threes, man, because I'm tired of this.
Oh, let's play those guys again. Take that spot. Oh, no, they started in your game, right? How about these? Oh. Well, let's go to threes then. Let's go meet up this guy over here.
I don't know where you're at, but I'll go.
The right side. Oh, Roy came through.
Right top, middle, or bottom?
Right here.
Right, middle, top, or bottom?
Look at the map, bro.
You're not in my squad. I can't see where you are.
Right there. You're at the top, above you, behind you.
No, but just tell me which one is it. Is it top right? Bottom right?
It's middle right.
Thank you, sir.
It's left top bottom.
Yo, what up?
All right, you got to go all out. Go all out on this one, man. Do you. Ball handle, bring it up, make a play, get some shots if you get it. If not, kick it out, make a play for me. Four assists, 12 points. Can you do that?
A what?
Four assists, 12 points. Actually, I gotta change this to threes and fives. Go. I don't know if it let me. Nope, it didn't. It's okay. Let's get it, man. It was like a little crew. All 40s. Here we go. What are you doing out of bounds?
I should glitch, bro. Dude. I was like, what the hell's going on? I thought it was... you didn't feel that?
This dude be trolling me, bro. Why is he doubling my guy, bro? What is this, a five-year-old? I can't make this up. This guy, bro. Do you, man. Nah, bro. Ooh, okay. He's definitely a five-year-old. Look at his defense. Watch. Gonna switch in a second again. Give me the ball, fool. Thank you, sir. That's the ball, Kobe. Man. Do you not know I could shoot? Think I'm... Get it, let's get it. Oh, that's my bad. I should have helped. I got you. Hey, come over here, Doughboy. Bruh. I got like an 80 overall dribble. And you have to be controlling this game, bro. You got a 90 on everything. Let it go early. Don't do it, homie. I'm big. Oh, good rebound, though. Damn it. Oh, wait, come over here. Thank you, sir. Oh, yes, sir. Probably shouldn't be doing contact layups, but that's all right. I'll take it. No, I know, I know. Oh, he got me. He got me. Come on, bro. This guy's selling, bro. Are you serious? He's working for them, bro. That's one of his friends. They're friends. What a douchebag, bro. Look at this. Look at this. He did it again. Come on, 2K. We got to report this guy, bro. He's selling. Yo. He just sold. He just sold. We went into the court with a random. That's why. Simbo. Oh. Harsh reality, no way. Yes, I would try to do that quick because 2K is kind of a little glitchy with it. This is it's a permanent one from what I'm seeing, but I'm gonna get it done. I don't trust it. All right. So you getting out of here?
Yeah.
All right, man. I'm out the chat, man. Have a good night, bro. Peace. It's my boy, Plotty Chip. Early rough games. Again, he doesn't play online much. It's all good. We got to just let loose more. I just got to get in games with him and just relax. You know, I think I put too much pressure on him to perform, and I want him to be great, and I think that's my fault. So I got to do better. I'm probably gonna get offline here, guys. I actually only got on for him. I was working on this project for the future and pretty much spent all day on it. Actually, I should get off all type of devices. I was on the screen from the morning to the night just doing some research on some things that I need to do, and pretty much already prepped for it, more or less. I just got to do a little bit of work. So today was research. Tomorrow is actually get the work done. I always tell people to do your research on whatever it is you're about to get into. It's important. And then you go from there. But today you saw a dude that didn't dribble good figure out his thing. What's this project you got, Mac? It's kind of private right now. I can't disclose anything, but it's a money thing. I'll just tell you that. It's something I don't normally do. Everything I do is for the love. Like, you see the Apex events I host. It's very public. I mean, it's very personal. It's very like community based for me, but this new project is financial growth. And I don't like that because I always like life purpose, you know. I believe God put us in this planet to fulfill whatever purpose we feel most passionate about, right? So we all have these passions. I don't care what it is, art, gaming, music, whatever you like. But there's something you're passionate about. And the best way to pull that out of yourself is through following that, making it your purpose in life. So there's a lot of times I don't chase money when I do things. But that is a problem also because I got two kids, I got a family, and I got bills, life. And I've been slacking. So I got to get it right. Get it right, get it tight. But yeah, man. I'll share it with you soon. And if it goes the way I think it's going to go, I'll be a millionaire by next year. And or earlier. But and then I'll share that on how to be a millionaire, and it'll look like one of those fake stories, you know, those little this is how I became a millionaire type of fake stories. It's like, no, it ain't, you lied. But since you know me, you'll probably be like, damn, you know what, he ain't lying. And then you end up working with me, you feel me? And I'm actually not working with me. Honestly, once I become a millionaire, of course, I'm going to try to make investments to continue to have money for the rest of my life for my whole family. But I'm also going to share all of the knowledge I have online. I think all of this stuff I've been doing is preparing me for that. Be able to share this wisdom of financial growth, because there's a lot of money out there. Too many greedy people not sharing how to make it or giving people opportunities, and not enough people helping others grow. But the truth is also this, and I'm going to say this to you, money bro. I think you're probably happy being broke. Can you say yes or no to that? Is that too deep? Is that too real? And turn off the game, man. I'm trying to talk to you, bro. Damn. He'll be playing a game while I'm talking to him. But basically what I mean, and I'm trying to purposely poke at money bro here, it goes for anybody. We're so comfortable in our lives, we're comfortable in our routines, and we're content, and there's nothing wrong with being content. You can be a janitor and be the happiest person in the world. You can be, you know, you can be a mailman and be the happiest person. You know, it's not necessarily that you make the most money, now you're happy. That's not how happiness exists, you know. So there's nothing wrong with being content like that. But the problem is we end up becoming content because we don't see the opportunities and we don't have them in front of us to believe in them. And an example, I took a lot of flights when I was young, and I always looked at the first class seats and it was like ignoring them, until one day I took a first class seat. And then that first class seat, I felt what it was like to have true luxury, the space to move your feet, lay back, space to just really cool off, extra gifts, a hot towel over your face type of, like, they treated me like a king, and I liked that. And then I went a while purposely going on only first class flights, you know, and I would be traveling to New York, a 30-minute drive, and I'll still take a first class flight. I was in my own head. But the principle, and that's what happens, is you get greedy with the luxury, then you become a greedy, money hungry millionaire, you know. That's something I never want to do, but I do know that I don't want to also be content. Get me? So I challenge everyone, you know, to push himself a little bit, to go a little further, to do some research, to work a little harder, and not be so content within your bubble. You feel me? You have a greater purpose, and you got to live that purpose. You know, and I don't talk about God enough, because I believe that's a personal journey. and it's not a boasting, like, look at me, I'm good with God, you should be too. No, these people who try to sell you God. But I am a believer, and I do believe that the main thing he wants, it's not complicated, all the books and all the nonsense people want to try to add on to all of it. He just wants you to live a happy life. If you believe in there's some miracle, magical God, and all you believe is that he wants you to be happy, that's good enough. Live a good life. Live a happy life. And being content is a problem because it means you're settling, and you shouldn't settle. You deserve better. When I'm a millionaire, I'm going to spend a lot of time trying to bring the awareness to the world. It's going to be hard because my heart wants me to give all my money away. You know what I mean? Like, it shouldn't be starving people if I'm a millionaire. But I do know I got to invest to be able to profit. But also, I'll be doing these programs and trying to help the world in that way so that they can also see and feel like, hey, man, you know what? I can do this too. So that's the message, and that's where I'm at with it, with as far as like hoping that people also have that understanding that it's out there for them if they really want to go for it. So that's what I meant to say, bro. It's more about like even myself. I get comfortable, and you know, I'm going through a phase right now financially where I'm like, damn, bro, you could have done so much and you just let it all slide because you're so comfortable and you're enjoying yourself, but you can be doing more. You know, you got no one to blame for yourself. So it's one of those cool moments in my life where a little more clarity about my actions or lack thereof. Sometimes it's not about what you do, it's about what you didn't do. Yeah, no. So as a friend, I challenge everyone listening to take more actions. After you get out of your 9 to 5, you work 10 hours, take a moment, do some research, find new ways to make revenue while you're home and things like that. Hey, by the way, one of my favorite things in this game. Bro, what type of easy ass question is, which artist received an award for their 8 Mile movie? Eminem, duh. Eminem for sure.
Yes, should have made that one more difficult. Which artist keeps a dictionary of words they've created?
Which artist keeps a dictionary? That's got to be like Nicki Minaj.
Oscar-nominated actress won a Grammy for Best Solo Rap Performance in 1994.
1994 artists. It's got to be Queen Latifah.
I think you got me. Psych, Queen Latifah.
I must admit, I did not expect you to know that one. To be honest, I'm completely shocked. I expected much less of you. You've earned my respect.
There we go. Cool. All right, we're done. I just had to do that real quick. It was just a silly little thing, man. I don't even need to do that. I don't know why I did that. I'm just so addicted to those trivias. They're funny. But to kind of just stress the topic and to end it, for me, purpose is what matters, but sometimes you got to know your deeper purpose, which is your family needing you financially. That's kind of where I'm at. Like, you know what? My family needs me financially. I got to go and get some work done. You know what I mean? So that's where it's at, man. It ain't a thing but a chicken wing, man. But yeah, we all need to challenge ourselves, and we got to stop getting too comfortable, you know? And again, I say that, but I'm the first one. getting too comfortable. But I'm about to get out of here. I was about to get off the stream. I don't even know what I'm still doing on this stream. Where am I? Yeah, I'm gonna do a couple quick little like errands. This is my new build that I just made today, I think. No, it isn't. Yeah, it is. This is my 5'10" build. If you wanna steal it, feel free. Ready? I wasn't gonna showcase this until I had them maxed out, or at least at a 90. I don't have no VC right now, so. But this is the way he looks, this is the way he is. Everybody is gonna copy and act like they originated it. Cool, go for you, good for you. So I'm gonna explain why I got it like this, all right? So I already have a 6'7", I already have a 6'1". I have a 6'7", like all around beast, right? I have a, why does this? Why is he? Oh yeah, the defense. 6'7" beast. I have a, I'm trying to remember what I would upgrade if I did this right. So this is how it works. I gotta take off something from somewhere. All right, there it is. So I have a center at 6'10". It's amazing. The 6'7" build you just saw, he can do a little bit of everything. Incredible. I got my 6'1" build, who's a play shot, basically nasty. This guy's a play shot also, but he has contact dunks. He has small man contact dunks and pro contact dunks, and he unlocks a lot of good dunks with an 86 and a high vertical. His speed is a 97. That's nasty, right? He has perimeter defense, Hall of Fame clamps badge. His speed's at a 95. And then shootings at a 91. Just an all-around build. It's funny because the meta is smaller than this, so you can have a 99 blinders and a 99 handle for days. I mean dribbles, so you can have unpluckable on Hall of Fame. But honestly, bad players need the maxed badges. Good players can lower their attributes and have other things that they can unlock. I pretty much have everything that those guys have, but I'm way better because I can rim run and do contact dunks at this small height. So it's going to be wild, wild, wild when I do play this. But I'm getting up out of here. Hey, man, it was a good night. Thank y'all so much for hanging with me. I got a lot of work. I got projects on my mind, a bunch of projects separate from gaming that I've been trying to get back on the ball with, because something I let go a couple years ago. I got so comfortable with doing gaming only. But got to get back on the money flow a little bit. So we'll talk tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm streaming twice. I think I'm streaming in the daytime. And then again tomorrow night. So you're going to see me double tomorrow. And then Friday, I'm definitely going to be streaming, I think, all day. Depends on what happens with my mama. All right. I want to see my mama. That's my mama. Oh, yeah. So that's what's going down. Man, she's leaving in November, but I got a week with her. I got to spend time with her. I'm out of here, man. I'm thinking about life stuff. I love you guys. Thank y'all for watching. Sorry for the short stream and for the long stream, because I was just doing a tutorial for Dribbles. But thank y'all so much for coming by. And it's an honor and a privilege. Money, bro, you know what's up, man. Peace and love to you, bro. Link up. We're going to be playing Apex a lot more if I get my act together in the next couple weeks. By next week, I should be back. Hopefully, we'll see if I survive this week when it comes to all the challenges I have ahead of me. I gotta push through them. All right, but take care.